This video is sponsored by ASUS, who have just launched the Awesome Creator Exchange. And you can get involved for your chance to win a VivoBook Pro laptop, accessories, and ASUS goodie bag, as well as a one-on-one session with your favorite mentor. I am going to go through my entire catalog of artwork and videos that I've produced for this channel and hand that work off to others to do as they will. Let's just say it's gonna be a wide variety. I'm not gonna take it easy on it.
This is me dressed as Bob Ross Gandalf. I feel like I've gotta pick one of these. Let's chuck in a Jazza puppet.
Ah, yo, I forgot about this.
I'm gonna put a picture of a koala in there. Picture of an egg as well. I don't know who this is or how he ended up in that folder, but yeah, he can join the party. Oh, that's one. This is the Iron Throne made of color pencils. That's sort of cool, sure, why not? Ah. Got one of those lying around.
Oh, the Mona Lisa thumb.
Oof, good Lord. Let's throw that in. I have made so much crap.
Cool.
I now have an asset pack with 37 items. Let's see what our artists make of it.
Our first artist is Jen. She's a fully qualified graphic designer. Contributes quite a lot to our studio creatively and is about to take whatever the heck I just put together and do something with it.
I think I'm gonna try and make Jazza into one of his artworks. I decided that I definitely wanted to pick one of his drawings that he had done before, like this guy in armor with these really cool wings and this really cool skull. So I'm gonna use this as my main inspiration. So turn his artwork into like a different piece of art. I really wanna try and use photo manipulation to see if I can get a realistic look out of it. So I've tried my best to pick some of the assets that are in this folder to try and get some of the body parts and work on it bit by bit. I have had to go and find some other bits of like texture and just other body parts as well, because unfortunately all of them couldn't be quite covered. I am also gonna have to go in and probably draw a couple of things, but for now I'm just gonna try and shape it all out as best as I can. And it's looking pretty janky right now. I'm kind of really happy though that I'm able to find everything I need, but it's gonna be a couple hours work to really get this to look better than just a mishmash of weird things, but we're gonna get there. I'm gonna do a little bit of hand drawing going forward and try to really mesh it all together to look like one cohesive piece. Ideally, I want it to look as similar to the drawing as I possibly can. I want Jazza to be able to look at this and just immediately know that that's his drawing that he originally created. I'm pretty happy with it. The silhouette looks pretty similar and I think the theme and the vibe is kind of similar. I've taken some own artistic liberties and chosen some own design choices. Overall, I think that it's just pretty cool.
That's so cool! Yeah. Oh, I love it.
Point out to me all the stuff you've repurposed.
I think it was the legs, the body, the face, obviously, and then the texture of the body, and then a couple of
other textures.
I did
not expect that, especially when you said you used the greasy face.
Yeah.
I didn't expect like a tough warrior dude.
Yeah, yeah.
Amazing, well done.
Thank you so much.
Now, I wouldn't ask any artist to do something that I wouldn't be willing to do myself, which is why I have also participated in this challenge, but not with my art assets, with Jess Johnson's, who is one of the mentors in ASUS's Creator Exchange competition, which you can enter for your chance to win an amazing gift back and a laptop. And this was such a fun challenge because Jess has such a wildly different style to me, and creating an artwork from someone else's assets, which essentially entails puzzle pieces that I never would have had the style or inclination to create, really lets me explore things in a new way and try new things that I might not otherwise be prepared or even educated enough to try. So I went through the process of building these assets into multiple image layers in Photoshop, and sort of working my way through them helped me think about what I was gonna do with them. I brought them into Adobe Animate as individual layers and slowly but surely built these loops out over about 1,000 frame period to create this feeling of pushing in and pulling out of a picture frame that's constantly looping in a hypnotic way and revealing one of these abstract buildings warped and revealed in the center of this memory desert. You might also notice I'm repurposing these assets in the same way that my friends in the studio have been using the ASUS ZenBook Pro Duo, one of the key features of which is the second screen, which allows me to have a whole bunch of extra space to remove clutter and just have everything I need at my fingertips, including features like being able to use a stylus. And by the way, both screens are touch screens. It's just an amazing creative experience. Now, if this looks like fun to you, you're definitely gonna love getting involved in the ASUS Creator Exchange program and the competition that they're running. ASUS wants to be the lighthouse for unshackled creativity and encourage the free flow of ideas embodied in the creator range of their laptops. And the ASUS Creator laptops are designed with creators in mind. They're innovative and suitable for creators at all levels, with frontier pushing features including OLED HDR displays to be super color accurate and awesome graphic integration. So whether you consider yourself a high tier professional or someone who just really wants to have a proper go at doing content creation and being a creative, the ASUS Creator laptops are the ones for you to check out. And you can get started by joining the Creator Exchange Challenge. Starting from 18th of January, this 6-week digital competition encourages you to take one of the asset packs, recreate an image format, digital artwork or illustration, add your own flavor and new creations, and see how far you can take your creativity in the Creator Exchange Challenge. Check out the link in the description, get involved yourself. You might just win a laptop, and I encourage you to get creative because it'll be a good fun and opportunity to test yourself and try something new, is what I would say to the next person on this list if I trusted him. Murray, let's see what you got. He was the winner of the gingerbread art house competition. You guys voted on his gingerbread house. So he's got some tricks up his sleeve. A lot of arty tricks, especially with all the work he does on Tabletop Time and his awesome experience with painting that I've seen in a traditional sense or on minis, but never digitally. So let's see what Murray can do.
Okay, what have we got here? Let's make a start. The throne was really compelling to me. Gandalf, Bob Ross, the Snow White princess, as two stone guardians looking over this throne room that is located in the middle of a forgotten forest. As they're literal opposites of each other, a photo from reality and a 2D cartoon, I had to get them to meet halfway, which meant I had to smear and obscure a lot of the details on Bob Ross Gandalf and give some texture and shading to our princess. I'm in a good mood. I don't know where I am in terms of the artwork, but I'm feeling pretty good. Just sort of muddling through it, we'll see how we go. I wanted to use everything from this folder. So the question was, how do I make a stone texture? I could just paint one. Then I noticed the veins on Muscle Man and it was perfect. All I had to do was make an overlay layer onto my statues and they got this almost marbled effect. It started coming together pretty nicely. I'm a little concerned about whether I'm going too fast. I might need to slow down and add some more detail, actually put a lot more effort into the art. I'm sort of being a bit impressionistic with my detail. I might have to add a bit more, cool my jets and labor over it a bit more. Do I put Puppet Jazza on the throne? That is my only question. And the answer was yes. It had to be the Jazza puppet. I grabbed the falling Jazza asset, cropped him up a bit, cut his legs so he fit nicer, repainted his hand so he was interacting with the throne, and then placed the glorious Jazza head on top. I'm pretty happy with this.
Oh my God, this is... Wow. It's all here. Like it shouldn't be beautiful with what you've used. Well done, man. I'm very impressed.
Thank you.
I'm proud of you.
You've
taken my mishmash of whatever the hell I gave you and made something really beautiful.
Yeah.
All right, it's good. We're gonna switch things in another different direction. This time, Alicia is taking the center stage. Alicia is the key artist for Tabletop Time's roleplay thumbnails in particular, portraits and a lot of posters and painterly style presentations. Alicia is a very talented artist and I've given her a whole bag of garbage to sift through.
Now that I've looked through all the assets, I'm even more clueless than before I saw them. So I noticed in the assets there are a lot of red, fiery, and mountain painting, and there was lava. There were a lot of adventurers. I decided I had to do something with that. I really wanted to use egg. The egg was just too cool not to use. Perhaps there was a dragon guarding the egg. One of the adventurers was trying to reach it or trying to sneak around the dragon. I've done quite a lot in the first 30 minutes. I'm thinking I want to add some animated elements. Just bring it into After Effects. So I've mostly animated small loops such as a fire, the little character at the front sneaking across. I've also done a crack in the egg and some smoke from the nostrils of the dragon, just to bring it to life.
This stuff happening, this is like a film. What? That's so cool. So you've got the egg cracking and a dude walking past the sleeping dragon. That's so cool. Oh, the dragon opens his eyes and stops assist. That's awesome. Thank you so much, Alicia. This is amazing. Last, but certainly, Rob is going to be next. Rob's the wild card in the mix. I think he would acknowledge him himself. He's not an artist per se. It's like playing a game of chicken with a stick of dynamite.
Thanks for the kind intro, Jazza. I guess we'll just get stuck into it. Words cannot describe what followed. This is by far the stupidest thing I've ever made, and I love it. I took a picture of Puppet Jazza, cropped him out a little bit, put him there. I also stole the background from the Switcheroo card, so we had a background. Yeah, look, I've created something cursed, and it's going to get worse. But I will be the only one that incorporates every asset, I guarantee that. Oh God, okay. So this was a weird one. I think I finished doing my Mona Lisa rain and then I added the hot dog dancing before moving on to the Jazza head Hydra. I used all of the pictures of his 3D scanned face for this and it's shooting lasers at the dancing hot dog. Emotionally, I'm feeling confused.
Yes.
But that's the point of this piece. It's Jazza surrealism.
G'day, ladies and gentlemen, I'm Jazza. I don't really sound like that, do I? Rack off, you. I've got a showcase to get to. Oh, I've installed a hot dog man, the thumb Mona Lisa. Here's me as Gandalf.
This is like if I had a commercial.
Safe to say, I've done some pretty amazing things.
I love how
things.
He gave up on animation.
Yes,
I mean,
I ran out of time.
Larry, and this is a hydra of my faces.
It's a
Thanks
mess.
Thanks for watching. Make sure to subscribe.
Make sure to subscribe.
And that's the story of four people with the same asset pack doing their worst to my art. But the moral of the story, there is no real moral. Oh, maybe there is. You can do new, cool, interesting stuff in your way using other people's stuff if you get creative, which is one of the reasons you should check out the ASUS Creator Exchange Challenge. Links in the description. Thank you for watching. Thank you to my staff and artists for contributing to this video. And thank you to me for having made all those things over 10 years so that I could throw them aggressively at people today. That's it for now, and until next time, I'll see you later. Oh, my knees.